Hello everyone. So in this video, I'll be showing you all how we can take the IAI membership through the non-ACET route. So what is the non-ACET route? Basically, if you haven't appeared or cleared the ACET exam, still you can take the IAI membership, but there are some eligibility criteria, and if you satisfy those eligibility criteria, then you can take the IAI membership through the non-ACET route. So I'll show you in this video how you can do that if you qualify those eligibility criteria, right? So I'll just log in into the IAI portal. I'll just write IAI login. And here there is the option of back to homepage. So I'll click on back to homepage. Within the student section, go to the admissions tab. In the admissions tab, there are two ways in which you can take the IAI membership. One is the ACET route, which I've discussed in my previous video. And the next one is the non-ACET route. In this non-ACET route, there are a few eligibility criteria. If you satisfy any one of these, then you can take the IAI membership. So there are students who have cleared two papers from other actuarial bodies like IFOA or SOA. So you can also take the IAI membership if provided you have cleared minimum two papers from IFOA. And there are a few different eligibility criteria, like if you are an IIM graduate, if you are MBA in finance. So these are a few different criteria. If you satisfy any one of these, then you can take the IAI membership without appearing or sitting for the ACET examinations. Right now, let us see how we can do that. So the very first thing is there is an entire PDF. So just click on announcement for online admission process. This will take us to a PDF which contains firstly all the eligibility criteria, some of which we have discussed already. And then there are steps given as to how you can apply for the membership. So the very first step is to click on this student membership form. Applicable for non-ACET students. So I'll just click on this. If you haven't registered yet, so the very first step is to register for the non-ACET membership. So I'll click on this link given here for registration. Click on this link and you have to fill in a few details. So you have to fill in your first name, your middle name, surname. So I'll just quickly show you all. I'll give you an example. So I'll write my name over here. My surname. So I can put my father's name over here. Then we have the date of birth. So remember, the date of birth should be correctly mentioned. It should be in the DD, then MMM, and year format. So firstly, it should be 15. If it's September, SEP, the first three letters of the month, and then 1997, the year. Select the gender and the admission criteria. So in this, you have to select according to which eligibility criteria are you applying for the non-ACET membership. So suppose I have cleared two papers from IFOA. So I'll select this particular eligibility criteria. IFOA passed two papers. I will give my ARN number, which is the ARN number of IFOA. If you are taking some other route, suppose if you are a qualified CA, chartered accountant, whatever role number, membership number you have to put it over here. Then your email ID, this email ID should be your own email ID, which will be used for communications by IAI. And lastly, in this step, you have to upload a photograph of yourself. So the specifications of the photograph is mentioned over here. These specifications are mainly, it should be a white background. You should be wearing a dark colored dress, a t-shirt or a shirt. Make sure your ears are visible. Your hairs are behind your ears. So these are a few do's and don'ts for a perfect photo. Make sure the size is also perfect. Once you do this, you can upload your photograph over here and click on sign up. The moment you click on sign up, you will receive a mail of sign up, right? So after completing this entire setup, I will click on sign up. Once you have signed up, The next thing, the next step, what you have to do is, again, we have to go to this particular, click this particular link, student membership form. So once you have uploaded everything, you have uploaded basically your photograph and just a few information, you'll click on sign up. Then basically you are registered to take the non-asset membership. So you are actually registered now. So again, we'll go to the same link, student membership form applicable for non-asset asset students. I'll click on this. And then what do we have to do is click on already registered. Because here we have registered ourselves. Now the next step is to proceed ahead with the membership details. So here I will click on already registered link. Click on this link. The moment you click on this link, a new pop-up will arrive. Here you will have to write your mail ID, whatever mail ID you mentioned here. Make sure you mention the same email ID over here. Give your date of birth. Make sure whatever date of birth you mentioned here, it should be exactly the same. It should be exactly the same date of birth that you have mentioned. And click on get OTP. So once you click on get OTP, I'll just show it to you all. Once you click on get OTP, you will receive a OTP in your registered email address. The email address which you mentioned over here and the date of birth which you mentioned over here, right? While signing up. So you have to type in that OTP and click on get registration form. The moment you do this, this is what you will get the next registration form. This is where it will lead you to. So this states all the documents which you have to provide. So these are the various six to seven documents which you have to provide. Make sure it is properly attested, properly scanned, and properly attested. Okay. So this documents you should keep ready before registration. Then the next step is to just click on this checkbox over here. Make sure you all at least read the codes and conducts once. Click on this checkbox and click on I accept, right? So the next thing is, once we click on I accept, we get a small form wherein we have to admission form wherein we have to fill lots of details, personal details basically. So it will be residential address, it will be your permanent address, it can be same as your current residential address. So what is the difference? Residential address is currently where you are staying, it can be in some other city where you are working or you are studying. Permanent address is address of your, maybe your parents or your original permanent address. And then the employer's address if you are already employed. So it's not mandatory to fill this section. Only if you're employed, you can fill this. Then your contact details. And there are some other details which you have to fill. Once this is done, this is the last box, checkbox which you have to tick. Make sure you do it correctly. So here, whatever documents needs to be submitted, the name of the documents which I showed you earlier. So mainly I'll just give you a brief idea of what documents you will have to put it over here. So here, these are the main documents which you have to show. The proof of date of birth, basically your birth certificate, Aadhaar card or PAN card, then your 10th and 12th mark sheets. If your name has changed, so that name change document, then your final certificates. So these are the certificates, basically, if you are applying through the IFOA two paper passed route, then you have to put the two past results of the two papers which you have cleared. So suppose if I have cleared CM1 and CS1 from IFOA and now I want to take the IEA membership, so I have to give a two PDFs of CM1 and CS2, basically my past results for CM1 and CS1. So individual past certificates for the two subjects passed from other actuarial body. If you are a qualified CA, then you have to give the final examination certificate which you receive after the qualification. Similarly, same thing applies to other eligibility criteria. This is very, very important because you are applying through non-ACET route, right? Now, these documents has to be attested. Now, what are the different methods in which you can do these attestations? So these are the different methods of attestations. It can be an actuary, a CA. So make sure if these are not available to you, like if you are not in contact with an actuary or a CA or maybe a gazetted officer, so make sure you click on self-attestation. This means that you will sign your documents by yourself and submit or upload the files. So if any of these are not available to you, make sure you click on self-attestation. Very, very important. If you click on actuary, then you will have to get your documents signed by an actuary. So make sure you click on self-attestation. After I do this, after I fill all the details over here, I'll click on next. The moment you click on next, they will ask you to upload the documents. So you will have to upload all the documents as mentioned, properly scan it, properly attest and scan it, and then you have to upload the documents. The next step is to do the payment. So the payment for the IA membership will be 4,000, and this 4,000 is inclusive of the IA membership and the annual membership charge, which they take on all, which falls due on 1st of April. So this 4,000 you have to pay. Once you make the payment, you will get a payment receipt. Make sure you have a copy of that payment receipt with yourself, so you can download it as a PDF and keep it with yourself, or you can get it printed out. Once you do this, you also receive a payment confirmation in your email ID, and then you have to basically submit all the scanned documents. After you submit all the scanned documents, within a 7 days of time span, within a 7 days of time span, you will receive the confirmation from the IA on your membership. So I'll just read you all through the steps over here, which are mentioned. So first of all, what we did was we uploaded all the documents. The payment was done. You will get a confirmation approval on your registered email address regarding the payment which you have made. If there was any kind of failure during the payment, they will ask you to try again. So you have to redo the entire process basically. And then again, within the 7 days, you will receive the status. You will receive an email on the status of your uploaded soft copies. So either they will accept everything, or there might be some of the mistakes which you might have made, maybe regarding the photograph which you uploaded or any of the documents. If any issue has been found, you will receive the email regarding, properly putting up a proper photograph or regarding any one particular document which you might not have self-attested or might not have uploaded properly. You have to check your mail ID constantly every day once you do the payment, so that you know when the confirmation has arrived, or if there is any failure in the process, you have to redo that particular thing. So you maybe have to upload one particular document, or you may have to upload one particular photograph. Once you do that, the entire process will be completed and you will receive your ACTED ID. You will receive your ACET ID basically. You will receive your ACET ID, and you can change your login into the portal, IA portal, and you can change your password. So this is the entire process of taking the IA membership through the non-ACET route. So without appearing for ACET, you can also take the membership, provided that you qualify with these particular different eligibility criteria. So thank you so much for watching this video. For any further queries, you all can comment down in the comment section below. We'll get back to you. Thank you so much.